Is this like her villain era? Swifties, let me know. Is this like Taylor's like villain era where she's just kind of taking everything that's thrown against her and just kind of owning it and living in her villain era? From someone who's frequent at concerts, hearing certain songs for the first time in a concert performance setting doesn't necessarily give you all of the elements of the song. It's really predicated to kind of entertain. So I gotta go back and just kind of make sure I connect those and kind of get the whole experience.
It's my time, it's on me, I'ma make them believe.
What's good, good people? It's Big Merk, and welcome to Big Merk Reacts. For all my first-time viewers, welcome to the channel. To all the newbies, my new subs, glad to have y'all as a part of the community. Thanks for locking in with me. And for those who've been rocking with me for the last few vids, and you guys have been around, thank you for coming back. Your support and your viewership is greatly appreciated. So, boom. Last episode, I blind reacted to Ready For It by Taylor Swift. And I, in fact, was not ready for it. It was not what I was expecting at all, but it was so, so good. Such a bop. The vibes, the energy, the metaphors and the lyrics and in the videos. It was a dope experience. So thanks to all the Swifties who recommend checking that out. And also thanks, again to the Swifties for following up with all the additional details and clarifications on the song and on the video. Again, she had a lot going on, and there was a couple Easter eggs here and there that you guys told me about, and it really helped connect a lot of the dots. So thanks again, Swifties. I was told this was the correct heart to use in the Swiftieverse. So thanks again, Swifties. For all the additional context and all the support. So with that, one of the songs that you guys recommended that I follow up Ready For It with was I Did Something Bad, but specifically the live version from the Reputation Tour. So here we are. Let's get into it. Here's I Did Something Bad, live performance by Taylor Swift from the Reputation Tour.
Trust a narcissist. Oh, but they love me. So I play like a violin, and I make it look. Cause for every lie I tell them, they tell me three.
Okay, I can tell that this is definitely like splicing of different clips or whatever. So I'm assuming there isn't a just kind of open source version of the song from the tour available, so I'll keep that in context as I kind of keep walking through. But I can say one thing kind of off bat. I'm going to go back and listen to the studio version of the song, because I think, I'm huge into live performances and concerts, and I think that there's something that can get lost when watching a live performance versus sitting with a song. I think there's a lot of things that can get lost in the arrangement, for a concert, for a stadium show, that will be different from, sitting and listening to the song. So I'm gonna go back and listen to the original song just to make sure I'm well-rounded around the song itself along with the performance. But I just wanted to kind of note that kind of going in.
This is how the world works.
All right, so there's obviously in the Reputation's album, the Reputation album, there's like a theme of kind of rebellion a little bit. Like even here in the lyrics, you know, it feels so, I did something bad, but it feels so good. So is this like her villain era? Swifties, let me know. Is this like Taylor's like villain era where she's just kind of taking everything that's thrown against her and just kind of owning it and living in her villain era? Let me know, because that's the theme I'm kind of getting, at least lyrically, visually, from, you know, the lights, her descriptions, you know, the flames down her hand, you know, the fire red lip, the, you know, is this like, you know, is she in her villain bag for this era? Sidebar, I have a huge appreciation for the amount of effort and time it takes not only to build and arrange a massive performance in a stadium, but also all the little intricacies, the dancers, the movements, the lighting, the pyro, the timing. It takes a lot to put on these really, really big shows. And, you know, obviously, you know, Taylor, from what I'm seeing, is doing an outstanding job. One, using the space on stage. That's something I've always had a problem with, like with even some of our best artists. You build these huge, massive sets and you don't leverage all the space. But obviously, you know, her and her team, the way they kind of arrange this is to make sure that she's working all angles of the crowd, moving through. And then even, I don't know if this is the actual sound or if it's been edited for anything, but the layering on her voice sounds good. The timing with the pyro and the hits and the drops is really, really crisp. And, you know, she's performing it. She's giving face. You know, she's engaging with the crowd. She knows what parts of the songs they engage with and she leans into it. So that again, also shows a level of just being in tune with your audience and being in tune with your fan base and knowing what they're going to resonate with in a particular song. So again, very thoughtful, very clever, very precise. Don't expect anything less.
Pitchforks and proof they're real.
Yeah, this is definitely a splice of different videos. And it's just for fun. They're burning holy witches, even if you aren't one. They got pitchforks and proof. Okay, I get the reference. Someone, a couple folks actually mentioned the reference with the burning the witches and the pitchforks and all that kind of stuff. That was kind of denoted on the stairs in the Ready For It video. So I see the connection here. This is definitely signaling, you know, her just accepting and kind of repositioning this villain role that's kind of been placed on her and just kind of owning it in like a fun, rebellious kind of way. So makes a ton of sense. Now, thanks for pointing that out. Swifties, thanks for pointing that out. I got a note too, like her vocals are really clear. So, you know, that's sidebar. That's more like engineering thing, but that's very important in a live show. Her vocals are really clear. So I appreciate that too. It just felt so good, good. So that was Taylor Swift. I Did Something Bad. The live performance from the Reputation tour. And I mean, I gotta say, it was a great performance. It was dynamic. The pyro, the dancing, the moving on the stage, all the dancers, the way she emoted and actually performed the songs. It was really dope. It was really dope. I do have to say, I think there's a level of kind of disconnection that I have with the performance of the song because this is my first time hearing the song. On top of obviously seeing the performance. So I want to go back and listen to the song too, because just listen to like the performance mix. It seems really good. I like a lot of the layering and the harmonies. I'm wondering if those elements are still kind of present in the actual song. So I need to go back and listen to it. And then maybe I'll go and watch it again just to kind of get that additional kind of context, because, you know, from someone who's frequent at concerts, hearing certain songs for the first time in a concert performance setting doesn't necessarily give you all of the elements of the song. It's really predicated to kind of entertain. So I got to go back and just kind of make sure I connect those and kind of get the whole experience. But I mean, yeah, it was a great performance. Again, it's really not much left to say. It seemed like it was a lot of energy. The crowd was into it. She was into it. Yeah, I enjoyed it. It was cool. It was cool. I gotta say, so far, man, it's all good. Like I have nothing but praise to offer. But again, you know, when you talk about artists at this scale, there aren't many missteps. You know what I'm saying? There aren't many missteps, and everything that they do typically is done really, really well. And it's just kind of a matter of taste and preference. But I'm impressed. You know, low key, it might be. I might be on my way to becoming a Swiftie myself. You know, I was just saying, it's on the table. I'm vibing with it. I'm feeling it. So we'll see as we continue to go along. If there's anything that you guys specifically want me to react to, please drop them in the comments. I will absolutely make it happen. Also, don't forget to subscribe and like this video. Am I missing something? Hit that notification bell so that you guys can be notified every time a new video drops. Really enjoyed this. Really enjoying this Taylor journey that I'm going on. Learning more about her. Learning more about the music and the performance and the background and the context of everything. So thank you guys for going along on the journey with me. We got a few more stops. I know she has an album coming out, I believe, this week. So maybe, you know, that's what we top off the entire Taylor journey with, doing a review of. Hopefully she drops a video or drops something to kind of get us rolling on the album coming out. So looking forward to that. But again, love it. Here for the vibes. It's been a good time. It's been a good ride. So until next time, make sure you guys stay tuned. Stay dangerous. It's love. Later.
It's my time.